Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. In today's video, we are going to have a little color grade tutorial. It is a super simple little thing, but I hope you will find it useful. We are going to take this image, as you see right here, and then we are going to do a grade, so it will look just like this. Anyway, I do hope you find these kinds of videos useful. If you do and are into filmmaking content or learning DaVinci Resolve, please hit that subscriber button and join the subscriber squad. And if you want some of my recommendations for gear, please look down in the gear sections down in the description below. So that is enough of me talking. Let's go to the tutorial. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 16.1 Beta 2, and this is the clip we are going to work with. So this is just a little Cinema GNG clip. I am working with shot on the production camera. So first off, I am going to stabilize my shot, and I'm also going to make it look like a locked off a camera shot, just to make things a little bit easier for me in general. So the look we are going to create here is we're actually going to make the river, as you see in the picture, look like it wasn't green of pollution and nice. So that's the basic thing we're going to do. So here we have the stabilization already, and that is super handy that the stabilization now is in the inspector in DaVinci Resolve, actually. Pretty nice. So we'll just make the clip a little bit shorter, and then we'll go to the color tab here. And in the color tab, we'll go to the raw settings and go to project and set it to clip. And as you see now, I'll just highlight the recovery. I'll turn that on and off, and you will see that that actually is doing a lot on these concrete pillars. And then I'm going to change our color temperature to 5600, and again just give a little with the tint here and maybe boost the exposure just a tad, and then I can then recover some highlights if I needed to, and I'll do that just like so. And you know, just keep your look at the scopes, that will help you out. And then again, the shadows, I am going to make those a little darker. I'm going to give it a little bit of color boost, not too much, and some saturation. And contrast, I'll give it a bit of contrast as well. Actually, I'll reset that, and I'll do that in here as instead in the color wheels. So one thing you could think about when you see these color grading things, you are thinking about the wheels, then you want to move those, but I'll show you a different way of working. Actually, if you work down here in with the contrast, and we can then set the dark and then use the pivot to make it a little bit better. And then in the saturation, I'm just going to give it some saturation. And then I'll go to number 2 right here, and then I'll go to the color temperature, and I might change that a bit. If I wanted to make it very blue and cold, I could do that, but I do not want to. I want to make it kind of warm, but not too warm. And then again, I can adjust the thing in the tint, and then I can just give it a bit of color boost. So this is the basic. So let's just push Control S to do a new note. And here we are going to take a window. In the windows, we are going to make a curve, or we're just going to draw a shape on the water here. I'll just zoom in using my middle mouse button, which is awesome to have. If you do not have a mouse with that, throw it away. And then I'll just kind of make the shape here of the water. Something like this. And zoom out again, and then I'll just close my mask. And then I am simply just going to take the blue color here and drag it in the gain towards the blue. And then I'll go, you know, you can make it look a lot of different colors, but if I look at these old photos from this location from way back, the water was not like blue, but more than the green it is now. And we are doing this a bit exaggerated anyways. So we're just going to, in the gain, going to lift the highlights a bit, and then in the midtones we're going to push that, and the lift we're going to drag that down a bit, and then I'll just do a new note, and I'll just go back to the old note here and take off the mask properties, and then I am going to soften the just a little bit to make it blur a little bit at the mask, something like this. Great. Okay. Okay, let's see if we want to do something more to this image. Actually, let's add a outside note. So what an outside note is now, if I want to do a correction, which are going to affect everything except my blue water. So if I wanted to do something, I'm just going to make a little bit of space here. So if I wanted to make something, change something in the image, I could, for instance, use the offset and I'll turn everything up or down. Maybe I want to have it a little across the blacks, just a little off everything here. And yeah, something like that. So, and this has not affected the blue water at all. So now I'll just show you a little thing. I like to put these output blankings on because it looks like film very fast. So now we have a shot that looks kind of like a film. So we go from this image to this image. And then, of course, we could go back to the edit, and to sell this effect a little bit better, we could just do a super simple camera movement. Let's do some kind of a pan. So let's go to the position, that one. Let's just reset that, wrong one. And then just do a pan movement. So we're just going to figure out where our border is, and we're going to put in a keyframe, go to the end of the clip, and let's set another keyframe where we wanted to, let's say when the car is around the bridge, our movement should stop. And then we wanted to go a little bit down. Whoops, too much. Okay, my mouth is very sensitive for these things. So something like this. So here we have the effect with a pan applied, and it helps selling the effect a little bit. The water might be pretty darn blue compared to what it was back in the day, but it looks nice. It looks not too realistic. Okay. So one little thing we could do also, it's not, you don't need to do this actually. If we go back to our water here, and let's just take out our mask so it's not visible. And then if we wanted to do something to the water, we could mess around with the midtones, either to make it more blurry or more soft, or to make it more detailed with the waves. So just something to keep in mind that is also a option to do in DaVinci Resolve with the midtone details. Anyway, I do hope you found this little tutorial useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.